Babel files like this that re-export modules can provide a convenient location for us to access them. This convenience, however, comes at a cost. It can slow down build and test times, increase bundle size sent to the browser, cause circular dependencies, and other problems too. In this example application, we are being punished by having to load all of the components in this UI folder, instead of simply importing our button component that this home page is using. I can demonstrate this by running two builds, the first like this, and the second where we import the button component directly instead of using the barrel. As you can see, we've got quite a large bundle size and the first load amount of JavaScript. Now let's compare it to if we point our import directly to the button component. Greatly reduced. We can mitigate the problems these barrel files cause in a Next.js application by utilizing a relatively new option built into its configuration called Optimize Package Imports. I found out about this option in a blog post I read on Vercel a while ago. I will link to the post below, which talks about the topic in greater detail. But to summarize, the Next.js team looked at reducing import times by bypassing barrel files and directly importing the required modules. They say this method decreased cold boot times by up to 40% and build times by 28%, significantly improving local development speed and production performance. To utilize this option, all we need to do is simply add our module path that we want to optimize. Let's see what difference it makes. So there we go, much better. And this resulted in the same performance as if we were directly importing the component. We can, however, improve this further. Now we are not tied down by the other files in the exported barrel, we can remove the use client directive in the homepage. And this should further reduce the numbers we are seeing. And there we go. It might not seem like much, but these values do add up over time, and this is a very small example highlighting the problem. Barrel files are not for everyone, and you should weigh up the pros and cons yourself and decide if you want to use them in the apps you build. Be sure to subscribe if you don't want to miss out future tips like this. The code used in the video will be linked down below for you to check out if you want to. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.